Generally, the idea is to start with your journey. And how did you soak your feet in it, in this music first, before you immersed yourself fully and you knew this is what you were going to do? So can you take us through this journey of how you encountered this music and how did it all start?
So it started, I can say, when I was about 3 years old. When I used to sing Sarigama to tune, and in the same pitch as whoever was singing along with me. That's when my parents noticed that I had some sort of inclination, and then back then Pandit Jalal Vasant, I used to live pretty close to where he was, and he was somebody who was who liked to teach young kids. You know, it's very difficult to teach kids who are 3 and 4. He was somebody who specialized in it. And I was fortunate to go there. And for people who don't know who Pandit Jalal Vasant is, he's the guru of Suresh Vadkarji. So, yeah. So, he, that's where I started. I just was very happy to get into that class. I was very little. And everybody was skeptical whether I'd sit through it, and I did, and I would sit for hours on end and didn't want to go back home. Unfortunately, Guruji passed away when I was barely 9 years old. And we happened to be in Rhythm House one particular day, and there was Ashwini Bhide's music playing in the background, and that's when my daughter to learn from this lady. And my mom says, no, she will learn from Veena Sahasrabhute. So they had a store. So they went up to Mr. Karmali, who is the owner of that store, and they told him that this is the thing. He says, Are aapki beti bahut choti hai. You send her to Manik Bhide, her mother, who is a super teacher. So that's how I reached Manik Tai. We didn't know of Manik Tai till then. I mean, my family was not so much into classical music. You see, they used to listen, but they didn't know who Manik Bhide was till this incident. And that's how I've reached Manik Bhide. And when I went to her, she refused to teach me. She said, and obviously I've gone there with so much expectation, and my face dropped, and then she said, "Acha kuch ga do, you know, aayi ho to." So me and my, I was about 10, and I said, "Haha, main multari gaun." Her husband, who was sitting inside, we call him Bhau, came out. "Kon gaate hai? Who's the person singing?" Then she said, "Ab kuch light bhi ga do." So the only piece that I knew, because my mom was a big fan of Veena Sahasrabhute, I knew her Ghatta Ghatta Mein by heart, with every variety and every pause, everything. So I just sang that. And as I was leaving, she said, "Haan, toh kab se aoge?"
How sweet.
No, the reason she didn't want to teach me is her reason was that she taught Ashwini Tandli after she completed her 10th grade. And I was much younger than that.
Right.
So. So yeah, so I was the first student with Manik Tai who was a school going.
Right. Wow.
Yeah. Wow. And I'm glad I got to her because such a fabulous person. She not only groomed us musically but otherwise also. So yeah, that's how I got into Jaipur Atravi Gaiki, and yeah, that was one part of the journey.
Okay. What makes me wonder here is two questions arise. One is obviously, what was the difference of learning with Jalal Vasanji and in the Gurukul that he... Is this the one in Khar or wherever that
now
is?
Now they... Yes, now they have an institution in Santa Cruz called Aji Vasan. He was... somebody was multi-talented, so he would insist that everybody learn an instrument also. Since you asked what's the difference. So we had an orchestra. Each kid would play one instrument.
Okay.
Yeah, so I was given the sarod.
Wow.
Okay, but I was so small, I couldn't reach the other side. So then he said, nahi, sitar to ye baja raha hai, violin to wo baja raha hai. To bichara mere paas ek mandolin aa gaya. So for a little while, I played the mandolin. Then wo bhi unko theek nahi laga, ye theek nahi baj raha hai ya pata nahi kya hua. Then he finally said, kuch nahi, tab tha kero those small little Casio tones. This was a music class. Aap basic sikho, aap exam do. And we were giving exams of Prayag Sangeet. Though I was so little, we used to give exams of Prayag Sangeet. Through the various exposures, you know, because Suresh was also very popular at that time, and Suresh is was adopted by Guruji. We used to stay with him. You know, we had a lot of exposure.
And so when you came to Manikkai, you started. So when you came to Manikkai, were you learning one-on-one with her, or was that also in a group?
Yes.
How was that different from learning in a group? Like, what did you think were the pros and cons of that?
For me, it was very difficult. One, I had always learned, you know, things were handed to me on a plate. Alap one, sargam two, whatever, you know, it went on. So when I came to Tai, first I had to repeat everything she was singing, which was so difficult. Then hold on to the sa for so long. So it took her and me more than a year and a half to, you know, get to know each other musically. It was tough. It was very tough for me because I was little also. I wouldn't understand. But Tai was very patient. That is the quality of Manik Tai. She is so patient. And she used to wait for to kind of figure out that particular piece that she had given me. She made us repeat something 100 times also. But she'd wait. She's that sort of a guru. Telling you, I really owe everything to her. The training of the voice, everything that I have learned, it's all Manik Tai. Uske baad seekhna was very easy.
So, like, did she start like one round and did for 6 months or a year? Aisa kuch kiya tha ki, matlab, how was that?
Initially, she didn't because I was too little. You know, I was 10 and she understood that I would, you know, get bored if she had gone on like that. But kiya unhone do maine to chalta tha ek raag initially. But wo bhi na, she wouldn't teach me bada khyal instantly. It was first madhyalay only. Madhyalay ki bande sikha tha. Mujhe, I think after about a year or something, she taught me my vilambit. Yeah. Thing with me also is that somewhere I was maybe 8 months, 9 months into class and hardly kuch aata tha yaar. Isko kaun sa raag aata hai? Manik Tai had done Yaman with me. Bahut basic. And Ashwini Tai was there and you know, she was the upcoming artist. And she was singing in this Santa Cruz Music Sabha. And Tai said, "Zam aage bas." Aage bas? Kuch aata nahi hai, ha? Aage bas. Sounds like Tai bhi gaya. I didn't know what to sing. And Ashwini Tai, it was a morning concert. I still remember she was singing Lalat. And mujhe tu var sa lao ani ton pakad. Arre baapre, this is tough, yeah. But okay, theek hai, kaise bhi karke, you know, Ashwini Tai is Ashwini Tai, so she pulls on the concert. She didn't So, maine gaya, jo bhi, she used to repeat a phrase, I used to repeat behind her, sometimes sa pakro, you know. I think that's when Manik Tai realized that, you know, abhi ye time aa gaya, isko seekhna chahiye, she should learn the vilambit, and that's how I got to singing my vilambit.
Right.
The first vilambit was also Moman Lagan Lagi. Yaman hi chal raha tha mera. I had then sung that, the first, I think,
correct
album, Tilak Kamo, then.
Yeah,
she said, hey, gheun za, hey, ghari aik. And fortunately, my mother had the LP player.
When Thai first came here 2 years ago, I told her, आपका मोह मना लगना लगे एंड सखी एरियाली पिया मेरे को पूरा का पूरा I had learnt it by heart. मतलब मेरे को पूरा सब आलाप याद है कहाँ क्या आने वाला है एरियाली कहाँ कहाँ कौन सा लयकारी कब आने सब याद था I could just sing along इतनी बार सुना होगा वो
and Manikta is you know to keep the interest you know क्या क्या उन्होंने किया उन्होंने मुझे ना रंजिशी सही सिखा दी ओके तो ये भी याली तो चल ही रहा था इन द मिडल ऑफ ऑल दिस शी सेड अगर हे पण गायला पाहिजे एंड देन शी टॉट मी रंजिशी सही एंड शी गेव मी रूना लैला का एक डिस्क दिया उन्होंने ये सुनो
यू 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 आर बस्टिंग सो मेनी मिथ्स राइट नाउ People think that classical musicians don't listen to light music. People think unko utna hi aata hai, unko to film music mein interest nahi hai, etc., etc. Without realizing that, I mean, there is so much interest in light music from classical musicians. They realize the value and hardship that goes into producing a good song in general. So I guess you've just busted so many myths by just telling us how about Manikta used to do, no? So from Manikthai, you learned from for a I'm sure you can't say learned you're still learning from Manikthai in several ways for a considerable amount of time. Do you remember when you actually sang solo like your first concert? Do you remember that time?
After being with Manikthai, yes, I'll never forget. It's such a blunder. So there was. I was given this opportunity and you know we as students I'm sure we met at around the same time you know we used to participate in a lot of music competitions oh I think that's where we met
yeah
right so I used to get very irritated and tell Manikthai you know I don't want to be a part of this competition hey kya hai 25 raag sangtar ani 10 minutes gaayacho I can't do it so Manikthai turned it around and said, "Agar tujhe 25 raag tayar hota hai, you think of that. Dha minta dao de, competition milta hai, nahi milta hai, it doesn't matter. But you are going to prepare 25 raags. So that is a big thing.
Absolutely.
So that's when I started thinking, achha chalo, nahi vila to nahi vila, but... So yes, so when I went to one such competition, somebody heard me there. And that person, I mean, an old gentleman, he offered me 3-hour concert. I was 17 or 18 or something. And 3 ghanta. I was shocked. I was not sure whether I could sustain that long. Okay, I was learning, I had learned quite a few years from Thai, but you know, to sing 3 hours, I was not sure of myself. So then I had Seema Thai and Vishwanath Dada as
support. Wow!
I needed someone like that. I wouldn't have survived. It went off okay. I mean, obviously you can't expect miracles from 17-year-old.
तो 17 साल की उम्र में आपने 3 घंटा गाया?
गाया
मैंने. Wow!
कैसे गाया? क्या गाया? अच्छा गाया? बुरा गाया? पता नहीं पर गाया. I was obviously very nervous. You know, I was too young. I just अच्छा ठीक है किसी ने बुलाया एंड इट वाज वेल अटेंडेड आल्सो
अमेजिंग सो यू सॉ द एनकरेजमेंट हियर वी आर सेइंग अ 17 ईयर ओल्ड हु वाज गिवन एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू सिंग फॉर 3 आवर्स एंड यू हैवंट मेनी इयर्स लेटर यू हैवंट फॉरगॉटन दैट कॉन्सर्ट बिकॉज़ दैट वाज योर मेडन कॉन्सर्ट एंड यू विल थैंक दैट पर्सन फॉरएवर फॉर हैविंग गिवन यू द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू सिंग फॉर 3 आवर्स You also remember the number of people who attended that concert, right? Roughly. Yeah. Do you remember what the, not audience response, but seeing 60 people in front of you, did it give you the jitters?
Back then, yes.
Yeah.
Of course. In that audience also, there were people who were musicologists or critics or, you know, people who had heard a lot of music. So there was a pretty, I mean, people who were into music and who had heard the great singing. So obviously looking at them, I was nervous, but I was also excited. I mean, you know, you're very young. Aapko sab kuch dikhata hai. You're in that, you're in that zone, no? You're much younger. So, jo bhi sikha hai sab, aata hai, lehi aata hai, not bother, because you're so confident. Awaaz chal rahi hai, everything is perfect.
That, those are actually the traits of a good performer. So, who is nervous before a concert, but once on stage, he or she is ruling. You understand that you have people are there solely to listen to you in that moment, right? So, and I believe that the most expensive thing one can give the other is time, is not money anymore. It's actually the resources, time. Because we all say we are busy, we all fall short of hours. And so somebody gives you 3 hours to sit and listen to you, despite you being young and all that. So from there, I know you were performing and learning at the same time. You've met several times and all that. What was the next big thing that happened to you in terms of your learning or in terms of your performance? What was the second sort of, okay, you launched as a singer and had your concert. How did it go from there in general?
So around that time, I won these two competitions. Okay, one was the All India Radio Prize for Thumri, and again the scholarship that the government gives, the HRD of the government, that again I won in Thumri. So I won two competitions for Thumri, and Thumri maine aise hi seekhi thi, one Thumri or one Thumri there from Tai. Of course, Sarla Tai, who was Sarla Tai, of course, first student, Sarla Bhide, student of Shobha Gurduji, used to live in the same building as Manikai, and she would come to my classes and beech-beech mein mujhe sikha deti thi. So, upar se thoda Sarla Tai dekh leti thi. So, you know, that about that Thumri aspect, I remember once I was singing a bandish. I don't remember which bandish it was. It was a classical bandish. And wo Thumri ang se aa rahi thi. And Manik Tai said, "Tham, mi Sarla la bolo te." And she called Sarla Tai. And Sarla Tai came in and she heard and she said, "Bob, this is what I wanted to show you. Hila na, I used to be in college or school or something. She said, please teach her in the next vacations that she has." So, unfortunately, Sarla Tai passed away that same vacation of mine. So, I think that Thumri influence somewhere rubbed off me, and I ended up winning this. Manik Tai actually was shocked because they thought I was more of a classical person. You look at the greatness of my guru. She says, after I win these two, she says, "Now you need to go and learn Thumri from a person who teaches Thumri." So, I was to go to Shobha. Shobha Tai was the next person to go to, but apparently Shobha Tai was not giving that time, and I was sent to Anita Sen. That's how I started my training for Thumri, and that's what I wanted to tell you. So that was something that was completely unexpected. I never thought I'd have some sort of fondness for that music also.
So what was it like learning from Anita Sen? I've never met a student of Anita Sen, so I'm just curious.
So, again, very grateful that I got to her. Again, she was very unwell when I met her. She was also suffering, having health issues. But even then, she was also extremely fond of me. And difference in the style of singing, like Shobha Tai uses a lot of murkis and a lot of expressions, you know, in terms of small ornamentations. That was so Shobha Tai's style of singing Thumri. Anita Ji's was exactly the other way around. So, "Arey, isko saaf gao. Ye kyun kar rahe ho tum? Ye aise aise kyun ghuma rahe ho? Aur jahan chahiye udhar use karo." You know, it was, there was a difference. So I had always heard Shobha Tai's Thumri's post winning the competition or around that time. And this was something different. So, jitna aap simple raoge, utna maza aayega. You know, that sort of was the major difference in the styles of singing. But still, she gave as much as she could to me.
If a good student goes to a good teacher at a certain time, they learn pretty quickly. So, because they learn, somewhere they start learning the vichar shaili. they start learning how to process a certain thumri. Like Shobhata used to say, thumri kaise nibhana? So what was her process? She never explained her process in so many words. But she would, if you heard her improvise a few thumris on stage and not in the recordings, because I believe the recordings are highly compromised renditions of hers. So if you heard her on stage, you would see what does she do behind the abhinay. And her mental process.
So much fun.
Yeah. So her mental process of how she handles the actual tics. Where does she break? How does she use the vowels? Where does the pukar come in? Where does the laggi come in? How many times the laggi comes? For as example. All that. Or kitna time gana? Matlab, the maans ki maaj mein chal raha hai, toh matlab, main toh 25 minute bhi gaate suna hai, but कभी कभी 10 मिनट पे भी ठुमरी खत्म हो जाती है. सो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द डे एंड हाउ शी फील्स. आई रिमेंबर द फर्स्ट पीस आई सेड आई वांटेड टू लर्न एंड शी जस्ट लुक्ड एट मी ब्लैंकली वाज बेर इन अ रतिया कैसे आओ.
वाओ
इट वाज सच अ सिखाया तो नहीं मेरे को बल्कि मेरे को बहुत बस शी जस्ट लुक्ड एट मी ब्लैंकली रियली दैट्स सर्फ अ लुक. इट्स वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट. बहुत बहुत अच्छा, बहुत खूबसूरत है. You're pretty unique because you sing thumris and you've been singing thumris for a pretty decent amount of time, and you've taken the effort of going to the right people to learn them and not just learn them from somebody who teaches khayal as advice by you.
I still learn. I still learn.
Okay.
So I don't know if you know, I've moved to Gurgaon for the last 5 years. I've been in Gurgaon, and I had this intense feeling that I should learn. You're in North India, you might as well make the best. And then Delhi mein koi tha nahi. So again, Ashwinita, he was very kind to find out. So there is this pretty senior most, you can say, student of Girja Devi ji in Banaras by the name Manju Sundaram ji. So for the last about 3 or 4 years, I have been going on and off to Banaras.
Kuch farak lagta hai Banaras mein gana seekhna, matlab in terms of...
So that's a different journey altogether. I mean,
yeah.
Bahut. Unki gaayaki alag hai. I mean, because they, ye jo hum log bhasha aise gaate hai, tumri mein ya kisi dadra mein hum log ga rahe hai, hume aadhe se zyada shabd samajh mein nahi aate na.
Correct.
They live it, they speak
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
So, they, तो वो लोग तो ऐसे ही बिकॉज व्हेन दीदी टॉक्स टू से इवन अ मेड कमिंग होम शी इज टॉकिंग इन दैट लैंग्वेज विद हर तो वो इतना इजीली वो लोग गा जाते हैं पर एस
इट्स लाइक सिंगिंग मराठी भावगीत राइट लाइक बिकॉज यू स्पीक द लैंग्वेज सो इट बी इजी फॉर यू टू सिंग भावगीत बिकॉज यू अंडरस्टैंड इट. I found the same thing. My journey with Thumri is also very similar. Like you said, more than half the words you don't understand. So बैरन रतिया कैसे आऊं तुम्हारे धिंगवा भी धिंगवा क्या होता है मेरे को क्या हुआ तो मेरे को मेरा वॉचमैन बोला धिंगवा क्या होता है तो वॉचमैन टोल्ड मी इट मींस पास आना अच्छा ओके सो हु नोस लर्निंग नेवर रियली स्टॉप्स ना वही तो मजा है ना.
Yeah. And does ऐसे लगता है अरे बाप रे कुछ नहीं आता. When you go to these places that you learn Thumri, hey Rao, you know हम लोग क्या सोच के गाते हैं और ये है क्या ये अलग ही कुछ.
Correct.
Because they live it. We don't. हमने देखी नहीं है. So the sort of stories that Banaras has is amazing.
So what do you like better? Do you like singing the विलंबित बोल बनाओ थुमरीज और यू प्रेफर द बोल बांट एंड बंदिश की एंड मिर्जापुरी कजरीज एंड व्हाट डू यू प्रेफर सिंगिंग.
एंजॉय एवरीथिंग. मुझे थुमरी बहुत मजा आता है गाने में.
क्या क्या लगता है थुमरी गाने में, मतलब क्यों मजा आता है, क्या है थुमरी?
आई थिंक आई एम आई एक्सप्रेस वेरी वेल इन माय सिंगिंग सो आई थिंक मेरा दैट इमोशनल कनेक्शन एंड ऑल दैट परफेक्ट थुमरी के साथ बन जाता है. ख्याल में भी है.
There was a Marathi film you had sung for. I just suddenly remembered you had sung for a Marathi.
How did you remember this?
मेरे को अभी थुमरी किसे याद आया. I remember asking you back in the day, like, had you sung this? And you said yes.
Yeah. It that was something I did for a friend. I had actually gone there to sing a bhajan for his movie. It was a background bhajan or something. He was like, "Acha, listen, you sing Thumri na, what do you think of this? Tell me, if you were to sing this, how would you sing it?" So that the lyricist was sitting there and usne shabd de diye. So maine aise kuch bhi, like I just randomly sang.
This wasn't a paramparik Thumri or anything. It was
No. It was related to the scene of the movie.
Okay.
So usne mujhe diya and it plays in the background of that scene. And उसने दिया आप कैसे गाओगे तो I sang ये दिमाग में जो आया मैंने गा दिया okay let's take this I said what there's no harmonium there's nothing he said नहीं चलो करो so tanpura me and tabla
I'm gonna try and find the clip somewhere
please don't it was the opening song to the movie Uttarayan
Uttarayan was such a good film. You should be proud of it.
No. But imagine, kaisa recording hua hai.
Nahi, itna achhi film thi.
But you won't realize it. Uttarayan ka jo starting hai, agar aapne miss kar diya, mera gaana miss ho gaya. It starts with my song.
Okay. Wow. I know you had a stint overseas. You lived overseas for some time. How was that? Was that a break in the journey? Or did you keep going? Or how was that?
I think once music is with you and you will know better, it doesn't leave you. So I think wherever I went, it really helped me because I was simultaneously working as an architect before I left India. And that kind of took a backseat once I went abroad. I think that's when music really came to the forefront. I was like into my riyaz big time. I think people wanted to learn, so there were a lot of people who came to learn. And that kind of helps because you're in it, you're thinking constantly.
And then you've done something very interesting. You moved back to India, you settled in Gurgaon, like you're saying. And you were not happy with the scene of music, to cut a long story short.
I should just say that there's a big void of any culture in Gurgaon, unfortunately, because it's a new city. So for every art-related event, we end up going to Delhi. And it's quite a commute because of this void that we found. So like-minded people who are art-loving and people who love music. So we got talking and we're trying to figure out, we couldn't find venues to have. Things and we just said let's just go back to where we all started let's just go back to the Baithaks why don't we just do it at people's homes so that's how we got into this a few of us got together and we started something called the Baithak experience we started this last year August 2019 we've done 6 editions And we've been very successful, thankfully. People have loved it. We have all kinds of audiences coming to this. People who have heard music from their childhood, who understand music, some who don't understand, newer audiences, people who just come for one and then they realize they've loved it so much that they keep calling us all the time, when's the next one? Batao, where is the next one? Who is the next artist? So yes, it's people are waiting. I mean, of course, now with this
COVID-19. Now, question for you, Baithak. You and I know the answer to this question, really, but I'm going to ask it nevertheless. What is the difference in the music that the artist produces in, say, Kamani or Siri Fort Auditorium as against what he would produce, he or she would produce in a Baithak sort of a scenario. What is the difference in that music?
What happens in a Baithak is, it's a very cozy, intimate setup. One, you are in somebody's living room. Yeah. Secondly, it's not a spread out sort of a auditorium setup where you have thousands of people listening to you. You are more connected with the artist. You are in a very intimate, close setup with the artist. So the artist can relate with you you can take almost, you're as good as taking part in the concert. You're more connected with what he or she is presenting, and she and or he is also more connected to you. So it is, I think that the closeness comes out more in a baithak, because the artist can take the liberty of doing things he may not want to do on a big stage, like say a kamani or a siri. He may want to explore certain bandishes he doesn't sing usually. He can do it in a baithak, and he will, you know, he will say it to you, okay, achha, maine ye kabhi nahi gaya, but I want to sing it for y'all, and please tell me what y'all think of it. He can take the liberty of doing these things, which he will not do in another stage. So yeah, so I think it's the connection between the artist and the audience that actually happens in a better.
Correct. As a gross generalization, very gross generalization, the true connoisseurs of Indian classical music like the baithak scenario, right? As against going to Nehru Center or whatever it is, right? Because like you said, there is a certain amount of disengagement, a distancing that happens. More people are vertically scrolling on their phones. So as against in a baithak, none of these are an option. So you're right there in the thick of it, and it's been produced for you. And how have you gone about creating an audience? So you said to me that some people, like-minded people, came together and said, okay, abhi ek shuru karte hain. You've used social media to sort of talk about. And was it just organically that your audience grew, or did you have some serious marketing exercises that you had to put across? Because then that
I think it just grew organically. We didn't think about what we wanted to do when we got into this whole process of the Baithak experience. It was just a couple of friends and music lovers. We mutually got together and just plunged into it. We didn't know where we were heading. We asked an artist friend to come and sing for us. And we had the first Baithak at my place. My living room, where we are right now, is where the first Baithak happened. And that's when, and we didn't know whether we wanted to take it to people's homes by then. That's when somebody came up to us post the Baithak, and you know, these were all friends we had just invited through, you know, we knew people who like music and things like that. There, this lady came up to me and said that, I want to have this in my house. So whenever you plan the next one, it's going to be at my place. So that's how the ball started rolling. We went into the next house, and then the person, somebody came up there and said, I want this in my house. And yeah, so it was like a relay of, I would like to call these people patrons, because yeah, so we had a relay of patrons. We've just been very lucky.
We have the liberty of not worrying about an audience number. But hey, let's just agree, there is a number that we all want, right? So we as much as performers like you and I can go and say, hey, we sing for ourselves, the Tanpura is my God and all that. Wo sab sahi hai, main manta hu, wo sahi hai. But there is a sheer business, there is a certain practicality that is associated to the business of music that one has to consider. How do artists get paid? How do they don't want to sing for five people, but they have there's a certain number that will add energy to that room and make the room nicely full. Given that you probably have 50 people in a concert, are there any high level segmentation of audiences that you've been able to observe, kinds of audiences that you cater to? And is farmaish still a thing in baithaks?
So let me answer your first question. Actually, I already kind of did answer your question. Like I said, we get different kinds of audiences in the baithaks. So, like, those categories are there. Some have heard music. Some have heard music in their childhood, but never really got an opportunity. Or maybe they've studied a little bit in their childhood. A maani bula class karo. So, you know, that kind of audience. And then they've let go of it. So, unko wo yaad aata hai, to wo sunte hai. So, that is that one audience. Then there is, there are people who just want to be there. Okay, so they are the wannabe audience. So there is all kinds. Bahut sare hote. And then there are the genuine listeners, those who either are artists or accompanists, or people who you know, people who have heard over the years that, you know, बहुत शौकीन लोग जो सुनने वाले हैं, I mean they heard, they can, you know, quote, अरे इस राग में इस आर्टिस्ट ने ऐसे गाया था, ऐसे भी लोग आते हैं. So there is a good mix of this in what I see in the metrics that we've had so far.
And each of these audiences have a role, and right. We're not trying to grade them as A, B, or C. Not one is any more important than the other. Each of them have a certain role by being in that concert scenario. Somebody is offering their presence there, so it's highly valued. They can choose not to be there, as simple as that, right? Okay. So the reason I ask if there are farmaishes in my previous question was to talk about an audience interaction that happened between the artist and the audience. Do you want to talk a little bit about farmaish, about daad, about what those moments are?
So, recently we did a series, 7-day series, which was digitally, it was done online. This was, of course, to raise funds for ADA, which was supporting artists in distress at the time of COVID. So, one, I would say we got a great audience. We just did it because we thought it was a good cause, and people were more than happy to come online, enjoy those 30 minutes. In fact, once we finished the 7 days, I started getting messages from people ke, "Arey, that's it, ho gaya, aur koi nahi hai. Main 7 o'clock every day, 7 o'clock I'm waiting for something to happen." So people just got used to it, and they loved it. And what I like online also, there is a lot of engaging from the audience. So, we had all kinds of artists. We had, we had recitals, we had some Gurbani, we had Kathak dance, we had V.C. Manjunath do the Carnatic percussions, and we had an interaction with a music critic. So, everywhere we noticed, people are engaging. I mean, that daad that we see in our Baithak live, wo ho raha tha. Jaise we had Danish Hussain do a story, Kisse Bazi, and people were going, wow, that's the equivalent of kya baat hai kind of thing. But there were kya baat hai happening online also. So there is, dono mein hai. Audiences mein toh hote hi hai, because that's a natural, it just happens.
I thought Danish was wonderful. He was brilliant. I saw most of it. It was brilliant. He was really, really nice. I have never
seen follow him. He's a great artist. Bahut mazedar hai.
You could tell he's from his energy, you can tell what kind of a person he must be, and the certain vivacious nature that he must live by, and you can tell. Bahut acha, bahut maza aaya. And he was checking on the audience as well. Log hai ki chale gaye, that sort of thing, you know.
No, he engages. So the artist engagement is also very important. You understand? So jo hum baithak mein karte hain, abhi jo maine bola, I said it happens both ways. Ye jo Danish ka jo tha, it happened both ways. So he was also engaging with the audience in the concert.
Sure.
Yes, and main bole ja raha hu aur aap gaayab ho gaye.
Nahi, sahi baat hai. So he was catching the pulse of the audience quite well, I thought. Bahut maza aaya. Bahut acha tha.
And he does that regularly.
I heard Sunanda ji also, I thought even that went well. She was lucky that she had accompanists, so it was quite nice.
Yeah, that was her husband who was... it was a tough one because she's in Himachal, and thankfully we had that correction.
Yeah, it also makes us realize, right, like how important accompanists are to our music.
Correct.
You need people who will stand behind you very firmly. If you fall, they're there to get you back. That sort of thing. The kitna important role hai. I think it's been demonstrated by this social distancing that we have had to do. So we started with your journey, and we are at where you are now. What lies ahead?
I can think now is I like the idea of being a part of creating this music community that we've started here, and I want that to help people also in the future. So one, that is something, it was an eye-opener for this year for us. Shivangini Yeshu, who is my co-founder, the two of us, you know, we've really learned, we've got learnings through every baithak, and we're hoping that, you know, it really takes off and it becomes good. It's a good thing for the community because itne artists aate jaate hain in Delhi. Why don't they just come to Gurgaon? We'll have more people listening to you rather than these people going all the way there. And you listen to good music. It's not that, you know, abhi suna bhul gaye. That music stays with you. So I think I'm looking at better experience in a big way right now. And musically, to music hamare paas hai hi. So that is, you be a student for life, like you said. Wo to chal hi raha hai.
Manik Thai wasn't a particular kind of person who would, or that she belonged to the category of people. She was from the category of people who did not talk much about their music. They did music. They did not talk about it, you know. मतलब ऐसा ये जो हम चर्चा गप्पा मार रहे हैं ये उनके साथ नहीं हो सकता था. As an example, she would just sing. The role of artists has also changed, है ना. मतलब people are taking upon themselves to sort of explain or rationalize what they are singing. अगर ठुमरी गा रहे हैं तो कोई ठुमरी explain करेगा क्या है. It's not to sort of belittle the audience, but it's to add to their knowledge in general of and give them a background of what's happening. So I believe going forward we'll be having more of these little pockets of good music, less so of gigantic audiences and Savai Gandharvas, but much more of these smaller pockets will create and curate the experience for listeners. I think you're doing fantastically. And I draw some inspiration from you also in terms of how you're creating an environment for yourself. And by doing it for yourself, you're doing it for others at the same time. You have to enjoy your own space first, right?
You're doing the same, Mayur.
Yeah, we're doing the same in our own way. Bahut zaruri hai yaar.
Achha, I said, aapke paas wo hai, hamare paas, not aapke, hamare paas wo hai, jise music kehte hai, and that's not going to leave you.
So yeah, first, correct, yeah. Exactly.
You know, this thing that you said, this small little, you know, interaction and this lectern sort of thing, and we want people to know about it. So, yeah, so we also introduced something in our bedhugs called Trivia. It's a very small little sheet. And people who have never really heard a bada khyal or a chota khyal or a tappa or a tumri, they get a small little explanation about what it is. So, and you know, a lot of people have come to us and said this is such a great thing because humko samajh mein aata hai, at least hum kya sun rahe hai.
So, yeah, I mean, generally, tumhara knowledge bank to badhta hai aur dusra tumhara context tayar hota hai na. Matlab, agar koi ek Jaipur, bahut, matlab, pure Jaipur gayaki sun raha hai. Like Manjiri Thai, for example, sings Jaipur the way she does. So, usko kuch to background hona chahiye. Sab teen tal mein kyun hai? Aisa teen tal mein kyun hai? Kuch to background hona chahiye. Excellent.
So, yes. So,
yeah.
These things are very helpful.
Yeah, without a doubt. Without a doubt. And luckily, we have good people. Yeah. We stretch ourselves too much sometimes with like work wise and all that. But we have good people. We have something else. You're very, very fortunate that you got such talent. Very fortunate. I don't think pata nahi, in that capacity, people will ever learn or ever teach, you know?
No, but you're also fortunate if you get a good student, yeah?
Main khil jata hun jab koi achha seekhne wala hai. Matlab, there is such a dearth of, there's no dearth of students. There's a huge dearth of people who have ये हुआ मेरे साथ, पता है उस दिन किसी का फोन आया एंड दिस गाय गोज लाइक मुझे गाना सीखना है एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. मैंने कहा अच्छा, ऐसे बहुत आते रहे फोन, तो फिर कोई दिमाग लगता है ऐसे इधर आके सब बॉलीवुड सॉलीवुड गाएगा तो मेरा फिर क्या पॉइंट है ना, मतलब मेरे पास मत आओ, कहीं और जाओ ना. तो चले नहीं नहीं क्लासिकल सीखना है. अच्छा, मैंने कहा ठीक है, बोलता हूँ दो दिन में. सो ही केम ओवर वन इवनिंग एंड सर, अच्छा आपने कुछ सीखा है पहले? मैंने कहा हाँ हाँ कुछ अच्छा सीखा, हाँ मैं लाहौर में सीखा करता था. सर अच्छा, वेरी नाइस, दिस गाय मस्ट बी इन हिज वेरी अर्ली 30s. एंड सर क्या सीखा है? यमन सीखा है. I had a feeling he would sing Ranjishi Sahi. I had a strong feeling he'd sing Ranjishi Sahi. No offense, but that's what I thought he would sing, you know.
And he sang.
No, he sang Mukut Paravari Jau Nagar. I was shocked. I was completely shocked. I was like, what? और मैंने कहा अच्छा और क्या सीखा है? भैरवी सीखा है. अच्छा डायरेक्ट भैरवी. मैंने कहा क्या सीखा? He goes, Bhavani Daya. I was shocked.
इसके गुरु कौन है?
पता नहीं, वो कहीं कोई लाहौर में. But मैं शॉक हो गया कि
wow.
All our assumptions, कि वहाँ ऐसा गाना and all that. He's singing all these songs, yeah. Come on. It was so challenging. I went and told this to some of my other friends here also. I said, look, this we don't even.
But it's so uplifting, no? When you get a
absolutely.
When you get a student like this, you're like, wow.
Correct. थोड़ा जानकार है, कुछ तो सुना सुना गाना है तो भी ठीक है. थोड़ा unlearning करना पड़ता है. गाना सीखना is not, because गाना सीखना is not a joyous process यार. It is very disrupting. वो तो है, unlearn करके सीखना पड़ता है ना. You have to take stuff in. ऐसा मतलब enjoy करके सीख नहीं सकते यार. This is the fun of it. Like we never sang or learned, or not sang. We never learned with an idea of singing somewhere. We learned because we wanted to sing. और उतना काफी था. मतलब उसका करियर बनेगा, उससे आगे क्या हमको क्या मालूम यार. अगर सीखना है काफी है ना. There's no such pressure associated with it. चलो, we had a good chat, yeah. We spoke for 2 hours. Nice.